Welcome back to the show that asks you, how do you ghost slide that whip? Welcome back to the Little Brown Jug Show. I am your host, Mikey Pedroza, and this is a show where I talk about swing culture and anything else fun I want to talk about. I'd like to send a thanks out to everybody who commented back on the question of the day from the last video. It seems like I wasn't the only one who enjoyed all the live music and all the social dancing during the week. Probably because of the fact there were a lot less contests this year, made for a lot more room to dance and be social. So I want to send a special shout out to Heather, James, and Katie for commenting down on the video and supporting the show. If you're a comic book lover like me, or just a lover of TV in general, then you know about Agent Carter, the new Marvel miniseries that is happening on ABC during these next months. And if you don't know who Agent Carter is, go check out Captain America the First Avenger. She's featured as the love interest of Captain America. So Agent Carter picks up after the war in 1946, where she's working for the SSR, the Strategic Scientific Reserve. And it has to deal with most of her struggle with dealing with the male-centric spy espionage world, and also trying to clear the name of Howard Stark, which happened to be Tony Stark's dad. And to answer your questions, yes, she was in the original comic books of Captain America, Tales of Suspense number 77. Yeah, enough geeking out, but the real thing about it was, of course, since it's set in 1946, there's gotta be swing music and there's gotta be Lindy Hop. You may have seen the pilot when Agent Carter goes into a club and there's loud, big band music playing and a bunch of people dancing. If you look even closer, you might recognize a couple of those people. Nikki, Shesha, Jeremy, Melissa, James, Laura, Joey, and Perrin. These local Los Angeles-based dancers all got different calls from different people to show up and audition for this part in a TV show. They really had no idea what they were walking into when they walked on set. But luckily, my good friend James, who also happens to be a comic book nerd, realized very quickly when he saw a wardrobe, and on that wardrobe, he saw a name that said Steve Rogers. He realized immediately this was going to be a Marvel TV show. The dancers were taken in for wardrobe and given some really classic, authentic, vintage, or reproduced suits and dresses to wear while they were on set. It was a long 18-hour shoot, but I saw that pilot, and it looks like they got some really good footage of them dancing. I mean, yeah, it won't be plastered on the screen, but at least they got some airtime. You can definitely recognize those dancers that were dancing on that floor. So I'll leave a link below where you can go to abc.com and watch the pilot, but watch it quick because usually they take it down after about a month. So congratulations to all the dancers, again, Nikki, Shesha, Jeremy, Melissa, James, Laura, Joey, and Perrin for being in this awesome pilot. By the way, I had my chance to be in this, but I was out of the country, and I am jealous as all hell that I didn't get to be in a Marvel film. Hopefully there'll be other chances, maybe they'll make more, and then I'll be around. Damn you, James! So right now I want to do a little something different. For those of you who know me, you know I've been dancing for a really long time. Ever since I was probably about this tall, I haven't grown much. And I want to do a segment called, Where Was I Then? Now if you're Lindy focused, you know and you saw the video of me dancing in 1999. And right now, we're going to watch that together while I comment on it. So, to the couch we go. Okay, so here we are on the couch. You may recognize it from way older videos. But I have my trusty computer here. And we're going to watch my 1999 U.S. Open Junior Lindy Division routine. It's going to be really interesting. I haven't seen it in a really long time. And I'll walk you through it. So here we go.
Number 11, please bring him onto the stage. Michael Pedroza and Cassandra Bjorklund. Michael and Cassandra.
So this is the U.S. Open 99 that happened in Century City. And at this time, it was the biggest audience I'd ever performed in front of, so I was crazy nervous. I couldn't even barely get up off my chair when they called us out. So the song is called A Military Secret, and I'm dressed in brown fatigues from way back when, as sort of an army guy. Funny thing is, I'm still bad at spinning. Little Dean's Cradle for you. I think we just put in every move that we thought was an LA swing move at the time and just put it in there as much as possible. Yep, here comes the first aerial. Luckily, Cassandra was so light. You just toss her all over the place. It was easy.
Don't give any information.
See? Really bad at spins. I was so heavy. I don't know how she held me up.
If you can keep a secret.
Now the thing with the routine is that me and her choreographed it ourselves with, like, I think 2 months in my parents' living room.
I'm careful whatever I do.
I guess everyone's heard. I wanna give all my love.
Big aerial. And the merry-go-round from the Hal to Kier himself. Hip trip to end it out. Oh my God.
Couple number 11, Michael and Cassandra. Give it up for couple number 11.
Yeah, and we did win first place. That was the thing. Oh, I could barely lift her at that point. I was so nervous and a wreck. It was crazy. That year was the first year they had Junior Lindy. There was a bunch of kids from Seattle at the time. I think there was 14 couples at that time, and we were number 11. Pretty much all of them, except for maybe three couples, were from this group from Seattle. And every routine kind of looked the same. And we came out there in sort of a breath of fresh air, you might say. Like I said at the beginning, I was sitting down throughout everybody else's routines, and I didn't get up once to warm up. And I sat down the whole time watching and listening, and they finally, the couple before us, okay, they're coming up, okay, I should get up. I try to get up, and fell right back down. All of the feeling in my legs, because I was so nervous, was all gone. I couldn't even get up. Another thing is, actually, I wore glasses, pretty thick glasses back then. I have contacts now. I know, LASIK at some point, I get it. I wore glasses back then, and I took them off, and I was blind. I could not see anything but my partner in front of me, so it was me and her, lots of lights, and a sea of darkness. And that was one of the best things ever, because I'm so glad I couldn't see anybody. I could definitely hear them. I could hear my family, I could hear my partner's family, and I could hear a lot of the LA crowd cheering for us. I was 14. And she was 13. And this was the first year they had Junior Lindy at the US Open. We come back next year, and Sky is there, and he competes, and he totally takes it. So thanks, Sky, for ruining my chance to win again. No chance. Last bit of info before I let you guys go. A couple months after this, we go to Baba McGee's, which was frequented by a lot of the old-timers, especially Hal. And my partner's mom went up to him and said, hey, these little kids, they just won with a move that you created. And he was so curious and so awesome and so generous. He's like, oh yeah, let me see it. Oh, could you imagine? Any of you who've ever done the merry-go-round or attempted to try it, to do it as a kid in front of the man who created it and the only one who could make it really look the best. But then the best thing happens is Hal himself went up to my partner Cassandra, grabbed her, and made her jump, like, and she just said, he's still really strong. So anyways, there you have it. There was my Where Was I Then. You can click the link down below to watch the whole thing from my personal channel and think for yourself or comment on anything. Thanks for watching, and we'll go back to the bar. Now I want to take this opportunity to plug my event, which is Inspiration Weekend, which happens March 6th, 7th, and 8th here in Orange County, California. This year we have international teachers as well as local teachers. Pontus and Isabella, Remy and Avita, Dax and Sarah, Nick and the living legend, Sylvia Sykes. There'll be a link down below where you can check out all of the information by going to inspirationweekend.com and join us and like us on Facebook. Come to Inspiration Weekend and get stoked on your Lindy Hop. So from all the Agent Carter miniseries stuff, we have the question of the day. What TV show or movies has Lindy Hop or swing dancing in it? I'm gonna exclude music videos from this because I've already done a video about Lindy Hop and music videos. So tell me those TV shows that you've seen or those movies you've seen that has Lindy Hop or swing dancing, good or bad, somewhere in the middle, you knew somebody in there, maybe you remembered a cousin from a brother of another mother in the background and you know that they were dancing. Let me know so I can check it out. So that's it for today. I want to thank you guys for watching. Remember, if you like the show, subscribe or hit that like button. Check me out on Facebook, and also you can always check me out on MikeyPedroza.com. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys later.